A very good evening to everyone. I, Cyrus Singh from grade 4.
Sanvi Jain from grade 4.
Welcome you all on the digital platform of BHIS.
On behalf of Billabong High International School, we would like to thank all the parents for their support and work towards our school.
BHIS initiative bring together working parents from various fields of expertise. They will share experiences which will motivate and inspire the students towards achieving their goal. BHIS strongly believes in the core values which inform you, your thoughts, decisions, and actions, and help you align your career or life path to what's important to you. They're the essential conditions. Life purpose, because they remain reminders and others who we truly are.
Service,
compassion,
resourcefulness,
commitment, and
integrity. BHIS Parent Talk is all geared up today for an interesting and enlightening session with our speaker, Mrs. Myra R.S. Sakib, who will be taking us through her life journey.
Mrs. Myra R.S. Sakib is a business person and a homemaker who pursued her bachelor's and master's from IIUM Malaysia. She always had a keen interest in fashion. Therefore, she decided to explore it. She worked her way through and started her own line of leather bags and footwear for women and children following the upcoming trend named Smith.
Keeping in mind her concern for the environment and making sure the products are eco-friendly, her interests include traveling, exploring new cultures, and experimenting with cuisines.
We would like to welcome our guest speaker for the day, Mrs. Maria Adipakit.
I would like to thank Billabong High International School for acknowledging us, working parents, our efforts, and giving us the platform to share our work journey with all of you. Thank you.
Thank you
so much, ma'am.
I got so inspired from your journey. Like the way you converted your interest into your passion and set up your own business. I have seen the quality of your leather bags and footwear. It is really very good.
Ma'am, we would like to ask you a few questions related to your journey and to your work. Also, students can ask their question by writing in the chat box. Firstly, I would like to ask when and from where you have got interest in fashion, and what was the one thing which inspired you to convert your interest into passion?
Okay, so I come from a leather business based family, and ever since I was a child, I used to look up to my father, his incredible and devoted attitude towards his business. I was deeply fascinated by his quality of decision-making, foresightedness, consistency, and most of all, his ability of being an impressive team leader. I then happened to study abroad, and during my undergraduation, I had to fulfill my internship, which happened to be at my father's factory. My majors in undergrad and postgrad were marketing. So from being at the production floor and watching the products being made from a sheet of leather to beautiful pieces of art. I was somehow fascinated by the entire process. And as it was destined, I was given the opportunity to design my own line after getting married and having kids. So I grabbed the opportunity and I moved forward.
Amazing. Also wanted to ask how you ensure that the products are eco-friendly and what all process that you follow for that.
Okay. So we try to make our products eco-friendly by using eco-friendly chemicals during the making of leather. We try to control water pollution via ZLD. It's zero discharge plant, where the water is recycled. Thus, the adverse effect on the environment is pretty less. We wholly believe in reducing waste. So we try to use the leather cutting and waste by making small articles like wallets, key holders, coin pouches, etc. We as an industry, we have a social corporate responsibility, which we can try to fulfill as much as we can.
Wow, it's really a great move. Ma'am, can you show us more products? And also wanted to know more about the international trade fairs.
Okay. So my company's export brand name is Mint. It's an abbreviation of Maria International. I look into the production and marketing of the products. From getting the products made to marketing them are seen by me and my team members. We also exhibit in various countries where our products are displayed for customers to see. Currently, I'm doing leather bags and footwear. I shall now present you a PowerPoint presentation showcasing few of my products and giving you a glance of how a trade fair looks like. So this is my brand name. These are some of our footwear for you to see. These are kids' footwear. Here comes the portfolio bag. This is a ladies' bag. And these are the trade fairs where I have exhibited.
Wow, ma'am, I love your products. Ma'am, other than your interest in fashion line, what all you like to do in your free time?
Before that, I would like to ask you all a question. Okay, Saira, Sanvi, or people who are watching this, which is the fashion item that appeals the most to you? It can be clothes, bags, cosmetics, or shoes. So any item which appeals you the most?
Ma'am, I like purses.
You like bags?
And kids' footwear.
That's nice.
Ma'am, and kids' footwear.
Ma'am, I like origami. So do you have any product made from origami?
Oh, wow. That's pretty interesting. So it's going to interest you that origami is not only based on papers. There is an art form called leather origami. Let me tell you something quite interesting about origami. Origami is not just limited to paper. There is an art form of leather origami as well. Let me show you a few other articles which are a product of leather origami via a PowerPoint. So you see, these bags are made of leather, but they are done via origami. Isn't it fascinating?
Thank you, ma'am. How has this pandemic affected your business and what did you do to deal with the problem?
See, the pandemic has affected everyone in all aspects of our life and business is no exception. Previously, we used to physically exhibit our products at the trade fairs. But now, since traveling is no more an option, we have resorted to virtual trade fairs, where we display articles online for the respective customers. We basically make contacts via social media and other online portals. Obviously, you can't compare a physical trade fair and virtual trade fair. But I guess for now, this is the best option for all of us.
Wow, ma'am. What is
As you mentioned, you also have interest in experimenting with cuisine. So can you share a bit more about this?
See, I have learned that time passes faster than you can imagine. And you should enjoy the simple pleasures of life. Traveling anywhere brings me peace. Exploring new places and cultures always fascinates me. Trying out new cuisines is fun too. I also like to experiment new cuisines in my kitchen. As my work demands me to be out, I cherish every moment being home with my family. I do experiment a lot with new cuisines. I have tried African, Thai, Lebanese, Malay food at my home, trying to resource the international ingredients or substituting them with our local ingredient.
Wow, ma'am. Why did you choose Billabong for your kids?
It has been an absolute delight to be a part of such a diligent and enthusiastic team of BHIS. Billabong High School focuses on both physical and mental development of the child. Even during these hard and trying times of pandemic, the teachers are doing their best to educate and engage the kids. It's definitely a commendable effort by the team.
Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, what motivates you towards your work and what are your ideals?
So, the idea of growing my business and providing a good recognition in the international market under my father's supervision is what that motivates me. I honestly believe in moving forward. Of course, there are challenges every day, but you need to overcome those and give your best. I would just say that never give
Thank
up.
Thank you, ma'am.
You never know what life holds for you. Always work and stay focused with a positive attitude. And that goes especially for all the girls out there, okay? Never ever give up on your dreams. Always follow them.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, would you like to give us any message?
My message would be to do your best, always put in your best effort, and always be true to your work. You all are still young. You have time to focus on what you want to do. You still have time to make your goals. So always stay goal-oriented. I know it's hard, but I know all of you can do it.
Thank you, ma'am. I'll request Saira to open the chat box. We have few questions from the students. So if you can please ask that.
Sure.
Someone asked, Which is favorite leather product from your company or your brand?
I think the favorite product from my leather company would be a duffel bag. A duffel bag is a big spacious bag which you can use for traveling. You can even take for meetings. You have small duffel bags as well. So I think that's pretty useful.
Ma'am, someone asked, what encourages you a lot while working in the business?
What encourages me, I would say my family. You know, they have been quite a motivating factor in my life. My parents, my husband, my kids, despite the fact that they are so young, they keep motivating me. I mean, they have their own cranky times, but yes, they understand that mom has her work. She has to go. And when I see this much of motivation and trust from them, it instills in me the confidence of giving my 100% to work.
Ma'am, someone asked, ma'am, what makes you happy apart from your business?
Traveling. I think traveling makes me very happy. As I mentioned earlier, I like exploring new places and exploring new cultures. And apart from that, I think even writing. I enjoy writing. It calms me. As a person, I feel when I'm in my leisure time, I like to write.
Ma'am, someone asked, how to buy a good quality leather?
To buy a good quality leather, you need to make sure that the raw materials used are of fine quality The trims used are of fine quality. The place the bag is coming from, the workmanship has to be good. It is just not, looks are just very temporary. A good leather bag should be long lasting.
And someone asked, did you have any problem while owning the leather factory?
During this pandemic time, yes, we all do. As you know, this pandemic has hampered the business growth of many people. And so, yes, we did face few problems. And as I told you that my specialization has been marketing, we are unable to travel, we are unable to market our products abroad. So what we have resorted is to do everything online. Since right now everything is online, we are attending virtual trade fairs, which I mentioned. We try to connect with our customers online. So yeah, it's tough, but we are going through.
How do you feel while doing this leather work?
Sorry?
How do you feel while doing this leather work?
I think it's pretty fascinating. It's a learning experience for me as well. I learn everything every new day. So it's pretty nice.
Ma'am, someone asked, what kind of dyeing is done on the leather?
There are various types of dyes which are done on leather.
We have got so inspired to see your passion towards work. And I am sure everyone must have been amazed to get known more about your inspiring journey.
Our heartfelt gratitude to our founder and CEO, Mrs. Preeti Agarwal, for initiating such talks which kindles in us the curiosity to explore more. We convey our heartfelt gratitude to our guest speaker, Mrs. Maria Arif Sakit, for the dynamic talk.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure being here.
Your feedback and suggestion is most important to us for raising the bar all the time. WhatsApp class group will remain open till 5:30 p.m. Parents and students are requested to share their feedback and suggestions on the class group.
Thank you so much, everyone, to be a part of this BHIS Parent Talk.
We will meet tomorrow on 18th July 2021 at the same time with our next guest speaker, Mr. Shailendra Jha. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Have a good day.